Hi, everyone. This is Board Games of Bourbon. I'm Glenn Flaherty, and right now we're going to talk about Space Explorers. And Space Explorers is a game that just entered the Kickstarter world and is already doing very well. It was designed by Yuri Zaravlev, and it challenges you to build the most successful space hub before your counterparts do. You'll do this by choosing workers, placing them into your hub, building projects, and then ultimately having the most valuable set of workers at game's end, which is triggered by somebody having 12 workers total, or when all the game's special projects are built and the projects look like Sputnik and things like this. It plays 2 to 4 people in roughly 30 minutes. It has a complexity score of 2.2 out of 5 on the BGG scale, higher than the two games I would compare it to, Century, Spice Road, and Splendor, while playing in roughly the same amount of time. The most immediate and most striking element of this game is that it replicates the 1960s aesthetic exactly. The game box, components, art style, even the sheen and the patina look exactly like the old games I'd find at the thrift store and like those old Life magazines and Playboys my grandfather kept in the VFW donation bin. The way the game works is as follows. One, you're going to pull a card into your hand from a draw area, and this card will potentially be a worker for you in the future or serve as currency for you to buy cards in the future as well. Two, you'll place your worker into a color-matched area of your personal hub. To do so, you need to pay for the card before placement, and the price of the card is stated on the side in terms of symbols. You will pay for the cards using three methods: using tokens, which you will pass to your left once you use them to pay, trading in other cards in your hand worth two tokens of any that you choose, or by reducing card units by one unit for each worker of the same color that you already employ in that colored area of your hub. Lastly, if all your workers can pay for a project like Sputnik, you can take it. This goes on until, like I said, the 12 workers or all the projects have been purchased. There's usually two more projects than there are players in the game. To determine the winner, you will add up the value of all your workers, and their worth is marked in the upper left-hand side. The person with the most value will win the game. The gameplay will feel familiar, but in an interesting twist, when buying workers using those tokens, the tokens are passed to the left from one person to another. This is essentially a catch-up mechanism for other players, and it helps keep the scoring in the game tight. Everyone is always in contention. Like Splendor at all, there isn't really any direct interaction other than the passing of the tokens, but this game does have the additional complexity of every card having special powers. Every colored area has a top card in that section, and that top card will have a power that is available to you. Powers are things like extra points at the game's end or drawing extra cards, etc., etc. There are 16 different symbols that are used in combination with each other. This is a lot of symbology and means a lot of staring at your player aid to decipher their implications. Luckily, the rulebook and the player aids are very clear, so it isn't too much of a hurdle to cross. Like all other games too, it will become faster with time. Regardless, however, turns are plotting because you don't really know the lay of the land until it's your turn. This is because the previous player might have picked up a card or placed down a card. Maybe they took a special project. And this means that you'll have to surveil the newly available cards, comparing them against the powers in your hub and your personal stash of tokens and cards. Overall, the turns are more thought-provoking than Splendor, but that which enriches the decisions could also be seen as the same things that deprive it of the simplicity and charm that Splendor gives us. This is going to hinge on your game experience. I'd play the game again. I think it's fine enough and sure to please those who are abstract game enthusiasts. To the novice, it will be like playing Splendor with 100 expansions mixed in. To Splendor lovers, however, it will be like me with my Pandemic games. I have the original Legacy Cthulhu, Fallen Rome, Forbidden Island, and I love them all. This will be another great addition to your Splendor-ish library. And so again, that basically sums up Explorers. It looks great, it plays easily, but there is a lot of thought involved. So give that a check out, see what you think. Thanks everyone, that is from me. I hope this has been useful, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.